One, two, three. Was fun.
Yeah, it was really fun.
Okay, so I'm Mark O'Connor.
I'm Maggie O'Connor.
And we are here for the tutorial on the advanced class. And we want to just point out a few things as you learn and work on this piece this week, and we'll see you at the end of the week. But there's a couple of things to point out. There's some really cool double A notes, and you'll see those indicated with stems going, you know, each way. And those are achieved with a stop note with the fourth finger on the D string. And in this case, those little lines, those diagonal lines, indicate slides, half-step slide with your finger. So basically take your fourth finger and put it around the G sharp note and then slide into the unison. There's a couple of different ways to get there, measure five, where it's a double stop grace note into the double A. There's some really kind of nifty triplets using the open A string. You know, maybe make sure you can do it on the solo D string before you add the A to make sure you've got the clarity. There's some more dramatic slides in letter B coming up into the note. So for instance, that second measure of letter B, so we do a slide into the A flat note. So you'll want to put your second finger on the G natural note and then slide into the A flat.
Also, I just want to mention, when you're doing these slides, I know we think with fiddle music, there's a lot of slides going on. It's fun and it's fiddly, but don't overdo it. You don't want to sound cheesy. So you'll see when we played it, we weren't totally over-exaggerating those slides.
Yeah, just slip them right in.
Yeah.
The slide coming down off that F minor chord in the third position, basically you kind of let the A note go, the A flat note go, and then slide down on that F, and then come back. And then over here in the third measure of letter B, there's a slide into that note. So you basically take your second finger and start it on a B natural and then slide it up into C. And so there's a lot of fun stuff like that going on.
And that can be tricky too, because it's a pretty quick tune. And also when we're playing in this style, the rhythm is so important. And sometimes it's kind of the opposite of what you think, in that it's really important to play long notes, actually, and to play very connected and legato, but also very rhythmic at the same time. So keep that in mind. Try not to put the space between the notes, unless you have some tricky string crossings, which there are quite a few tricky string crossings in this piece, especially letter B area. But still try to play in very connected phrases, because that will sound more stylistically like fiddling.
Yeah, there's a section right there in letter B where there's some tricky string crossing, but to land in that double stop where you pick it up with the up bow in measure 14, that's real stylistic. That's real American fiddle sounds there. And it also does the same thing at the end of letter B, down on that double stop on the low strings for a D-flat chord. There's a little kind of like a journey section where we go through a bunch of passing chords in letter D, which is really fun. And you got some chords and triplets. And then letter E indicates a little more of a jazzy sound with phrases that we set up with chords, like so in the first measure of E, and then it, like a call and response, da-da-da-da, and a little jazz line, and it keeps on going throughout. And then letter F, we end up back here with the same part as letter B, but the only difference here is we follow a DC al coda. The coda goes back to the beginning of the piece, where you just do it one time, you don't do the repeat. And when you'll see that coda sign near the end of letter A, and you follow it all the way down to the very final measure, where you've got a little surprise waiting for you, because we've got a little interesting harmony, compliments of the great Wynton Marsalis. And he wanted to put a C natural chord right there before the end of the fermata.
We're excited to go over it with you at the end of the week.
We'll talk about chords and some improvisational ideas as well. This is my arrangement of the tune, and so you'll see how different arrangements come at you from the different teachers that you'll have. But we really enjoyed working this up, and we hope you enjoy this week.